We are discussing the operations on the data structure. Operation on the DS meaning is that what are the different things that we can apply onto some of the data structure. And we already know the linked list, array, graph, tree, these are the data structure. So I am just taking the basic data structure, that is array, and with the help of array, I will make you understand what are the different operations. So first of all, we are taking the first operation which we can perform on the data structure, and that is called the traversing. So traversing, the meaning of traversing is that we are going to traverse all the elements. So let us suppose we are having the array. Let us suppose this one is the array and there are the indexes of the array. Let us suppose starting from 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. That means this array can store the 5 elements. I am putting some random 5 elements here. Supposingly the elements are 7, 6, 5, 3 and 1. So these are the random elements which are there. Now if we are going to see these elements one by one, this is called the traversing. We know that in the array we used to apply some kind of loop. We usually say that array will start from 0 and then it go till 4 and just display all the elements. So displaying the elements of an array is the example of traversing. Means we are starting from 1 and then we are displaying all the elements one by one. This is called the traversing. So traversing, we can say we are going through all the elements and doing some task. Maybe we are adding those elements, we are displaying those elements, or we are using those elements. That is called the traversing. So we can say that it is the processing each element of the array. So here we can mention that we are going to process each element in the list. So if in the list there are multiple elements which are given and we are going to process them. Process means, let us suppose we are displaying them, that is called the traversing of the array or the data structure. Now the next operation which we can apply on the data structure is called the searching. So searching is the next operation. Searching means we are going to search some certain element. Let us suppose we are considering the same array. Now in this array we want to search some element. So that is called the searching of that element. Now assuming that we are going to search some number here and that number is 3. So let us suppose I am taking a S. S means the number to search and that number is 3. And with that 3 number we are going to search inside the array. Let us assume we are considering the same array and we are having the same numbers in the array, which is 7, 6, 5, 3 and 1. Now out of this array, if we are going to search an element which is 3, so that is called the searching. So we are going to compare this element from the first element. We will compare with the first. 7, it is not matching. We are comparing with the second, it is not matching. Third, it is not matching. Fourth, yes, here our search element is matching. So this is called the searching. Means the index value or the place will be returned. Means the program can return that at the index 3 our search is given. Or maybe we can say that it is the place 4. We already know that index value is 1 less than the number of the spaces. So here we can say it is the 1, 2, 3, 4. So this one is the place where we found the element. So fourth place or third index value we are going to see our element. So this is called searching. Means anything we are going to search inside a list, it is called the searching. So we can write here, if we are going to find the location of element, so this is called the searching. Now we are learning the next operation which we can apply on the data structure, that is called the inserting. Inserting or the insertion, that is the next operation. Now let us suppose that we are given with some of the data structure, assuming the array, and there are some numbers available and we are going to add one more number there, that is called the inserting. So I am taking the same example which we have opted above. Supposingly in this array there are certain number which are available. Let us suppose 7, 6, 5, 3 and 1. These numbers are already available and I has to add one more number. Let us suppose that the number which I has to add is 12. So the number we are having is 12 to enter. Now this number will be inserted on the last. We are assuming that we has to insert on the last. So number will be inserted here. So this is called the insertion. Means we are going to add on one more number. Earlier the five numbers was there, which was 7, 6, 5, 3 and 1. So one more number 12 is inserted. So that is called inserting into the data structure. So we can give the definition as well. So we can say here, insertion means to add new element to the list. So here we have added one more element, that is the 12. Now the next operation which we can apply on the data structure is called the deletion, or we can say that deleting. So deleting is one more operation. That means we have given with certain array and there we have to delete certain element. Now I am taking the same example of array and make you understand. So in this array the numbers which are present are 7, 6, 5, 3, 1 and 12. So let us suppose these six numbers are present and we have to delete some number. Let us suppose the number we are going to delete is same, which is 12. So now deletion means we are going to delete that number. So that number will be deleted and space will be free from here. So this is called the deletion. Well, although we are deleting at the end, so deletion can be at anywhere or insertion can be at anywhere. So that depend upon the program. So we can say that deleting is removing element from the list. So here in this case the 12 is deleted from the array and yes, the other numbers are remaining same. Now there are some special operations which are there on the data structure.